All right. Hello, everybody. I'm Alexis. I'm a senior at UNH. I'm a linguistics and German double major, and I'm going to be talking about German today. I know a lot of you probably haven't taken a German class or know a little bit of German, but I'm still going to talk about it. And you guys can ask me any questions you'd like at the end. So I just wanted to put out like what I did in high school. So I started this in high school. I started my freshman year of high school. My German classes looked like German 1 and 2 for my freshman year. Sophomore year, I did German 3 and 4. And then my junior year, I did AP German, and I did not take anything my senior year. For whatever reason, and that reason being my professor, my teacher, we had a really strong German program. So part of my extracurriculars were bunch of competitions, bunch of like play competitions where like we'd have to learn a play in German and then we'd go and compete with other students who were also doing a German play. We did get first place in that. We got first place in a lot of things because she was just like, she would add it into the course. There were a bunch of other competitions. I know Vincent Weiss, like kind of like a German Shawn Mendes, came and played at our school. And we did like a music video competition and one of the students won that like throughout like the entire like US, and then he got to go to Germany that year. So yeah, just a lot of German in high school. And then when I got to college, I did not take German right away. I wanted to add the course names because I know that in high school, German kind of, or like language classes kind of just have the language it is and then a number next to it. But when you get to college, it kind of gets a little bit more in depth and you can kind of specialize it a little bit more. So when I got into college, I skipped German and I went right to Latin. So I took elementary Latin, 401 and 402. These numbers at the side kind of just tell you the level it's at. So 400 is a lower level course, whereas 700 is a higher level course. My sophomore year, I took Latin again, but I went up to intermediate. And that's when I stopped with Latin because with linguistics, I need two languages up to intermediate level. So I was like, all right, good, done. We're all set with that. And then my junior year, last year, I started taking German again. I was able to test into it, so I immediately went into intermediate German. And I also took an LLC course, which was Madness and Mental Health. In this course, we did a lot of talking about, it was in English, but we talked about different cultures and how they represented madness, which was very interesting. This past summer, I was in Berlin, so I took some summer courses there. I took a full semester's worth of courses. It was a lot, but I've managed it and I got through it. But I took B1 level German and B2 level German. Over in Germany, they structure their language courses a little bit different. So they have A1 and A2, which is like your beginners, B1 and B2, which is intermediate, and then C1 and C2, which is your more advanced students. I also took a German cultural class, and then I took this Europe Migration and Refugees class, which was very informational and very, very relevant to what's happening today in Europe and what's happening with the refugee crisis. And then this year I'm taking my advanced German course, which is Sex, Madness, and Decay in Vienna, which is more like a 1800s level course, or not 18, it's based in the 1800s, but we're just talking about like history in Vienna and stuff like that. And then I'm taking my methods of foreign language teaching class, which Chris and Jacob are also taking. So just some extracurriculars. If you're taking a language, I can't emphasize more just to go with the extracurriculars. It will help you immensely and it'll also be fun. So in high school, we had German club, the Schauspieler Wettbewerb, which was the play competition, and then other German competitions. In college, we also have German club, and we have this thing called Kaffeestunde, which is coffee hour. So we'll get together every other week, and we'll drink coffee and tea, and we'll just talk about things in German. We'll also have movie nights. I know they had one maybe 2 weeks ago where they watched, oh, I can't remember. It was some German movie about history and stuff, but they do those pretty frequently. And then there's also a bunch of presentations and lectures about German topics. I know last week they had one about like the witch trials and everything, and it was auf Deutsch in German, so very interesting stuff. I also did a study abroad in high school. The study abroad was part of a exchange program, but it was a little different than your regular exchange. Our high school did it in a way that one full class of Austrian students came over to our little part in New Hampshire in November. So I had Dominic staying with me, and everybody else in my class who was also on this trip had somebody staying with them. They stayed for 3 weeks. We drove them around. We drove them to school, and then they would go on class trips together around New England. Something that was very interesting to me was that Dominic had never seen a turkey before, so he was like, "What is that?" and was terrified. So we got the pleasure of introducing him to turkeys. And then in April, we went over to Austria, Salzburg, but we made a stop in Reykjavik, Iceland, since we flew Iceland Air. We were there for 2 days. We were all super jet lagged, and it was cold and rainy, so we didn't enjoy it to the fullest, because we were also like little high schoolers who were like, "Oh, we're tired and cold." But we did get to see some Icelandic ponies, and we got to pet them, and they were very fun. And Iceland is just really beautiful. After that, we went to, my memory's really bad, but we went to some place in Germany, and then we went to Salzburg. We got to go to the salt mines, and we got to just explore around and see all these beautiful places in Salzburg. I got to bond with my host family as well. Dominic and I were not the best of friends, but we got along fair enough. But he went off with his friends, and then me and his parents actually bonded a lot. So they took me to, I think, 2 operas and a play, and I got to see The Sound of Music in German. Can't stress it enough, it was amazing. But yeah, this was my study abroad in high school. And then this past summer, I was in Berlin, Germany. I was there for 3 months. The first 5 weeks was a UNH-based program, so my professor came with us. He did the culture class, and he taught us with that, and we also studied at one of the language schools. So we would travel about an hour every morning to this language school on public transport, and then we would sit in class, and it was a 3-hour long class, so it was a long day, but it was really fun. And then afterwards, we'd go on all these activities, and my professor was very excited, so almost every day we had like a different museum or like excursion to go on. I'm a bit museumed out now, but I know a lot about German history and like German, like Berlin stuff. And I also got to go to a dog cafe. I was so mad because I found this the weekend before we were leaving this place. But they had a dog cafe where like you got to go and drink coffee with dogs, which was amazing. They had the film museum, which is this middle picture, which was just like film and how it's produced and everything and the history of it. We went to Weimar for a weekend, which was this beautiful little town, but it does have a dark past because of the concentration camp that's right above it. So it was a little like, oh, this is pretty, but also like, oh, it's a little heavy. But yeah, and then if you ever get the chance to go to Berlin, go to the TV tower. This is the picture I took from there. You get to see all of it, and there is, I didn't get the picture of it, but you can see the split where like West and East Berlin was when you're up that high, just based on building structures and everything. So if you ever get a chance, please do that. They also have a mobile like app on your phone that you can download, or like a link you can follow, and you can actually see the line with your phone when you're looking through the camera. But this was my first 5 weeks. After that 5 weeks, my professor left, and some of us stayed for an additional program. There were 3 weeks in between that. Oh, sorry. So these were my classes. The one over here on your left was my UNH class. So those are all UNH students and my professor. And then these were the students who were in my language class. My language class was very diverse. I've never been in a class like that before, but it was so much fun. We had like a few people from Spain, a few people from Colombia, and yeah, it was just so good. they were all super nice too, and we were all learning German, so like you had to learn the language more because that was the common language other than English. But so my 3 weeks break, I actually went to London, England with my parents, or not my parents, but my mom and my sister and her boyfriend, because my mom has a good friend who lives there. So we got to stay with her. This is her dog, Scoot. He's such a good boy, a little awkward, but he is fun. At this point, I wasn't really speaking much German just because I was with my family and they don't speak German. But one of my mom's friends had a friend who spoke German, so she had me over for coffee and we spoke German, which was fun. When we went back, this was another 4 week program. We went to the Freie Universität. I'd already taken a lot of pictures of all the stuff that I'd seen in Berlin because I'd already been there for 5 weeks, so it was just a lot of pictures with friends. This was my German class. There was only seven of us. Yeah, it was super fun. We saw the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie in German, and we were all very surprised by how much we could retain from it, which was fun. And we also saw the Barbie movie, not in German, but still in Germany. But yeah, and that's the end of my presentation.
Good.
Any questions? Yeah.
Yes, I've got a couple questions actually. So, you saw The Sound of Music in German. So, the songs, were they in English?
They were in German.
They were in German. So long, farewell, auf Wiedersehen, adieu. What are they just auf Wiedersehen, auf Wiedersehen? How do they do that?
I think they did that part in English, but the rest of the song was in German.
Because the song was in German. Okay. Mm-hmm.
They also had. They have this thing in like German theaters, because I got to go see another show. We had a theater course, but it was for the more advanced students, and I wasn't quite there yet, but they had an open ticket the last weekend. So I went to go see this play. It was the Penny Opera in German.
Is that by Brecht?
I think so.
Brecht, Penny Opera, something like that?
Penny Opera, that's what
okay.
it is.
Yeah, yeah.
But for this play and that play, they had this, so like you have your stage and then they had this like line up at the top where they had like an English translation because I guess a lot of people who don't speak German go and see these shows. So at both shows I was able to like also look at the English translations while also checking my understanding.
Cool. And where did you go to high school? Because your high school had quite a full supply of German classes.
Yeah, Conval High School, Kentucky Valley. It's in Peterborough, New Hampshire.
Okay. And when you went, one final question, then I'll let somebody else. So when you went to the movie theater, did you get a beer, right? Because you can get beer at movie theaters in Germany, right? Because it's like, remember the first time I went, I was like, oh my goodness, this is a thing, and you could do that.
Yeah, so I'm actually not a big drinker, but my friend did get a beer.
So you can see, just to see, like, oh.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And one of the big things that everybody was like, super, like, oh my God, this is so weird, was that like you can carry alcohol, open bottles, like on the street and on public transportation. On public transportation, it's like, you can do it, but it's not looked well upon, if that makes sense. But they were like, yeah, like we can't even do this in America. Like, this is crazy. But yeah.
Mm-hmm. Back to academic. Sorry to be boring. Could you explain the difference between, say, being a German major and linguistics? What's extra about linguistics?
So linguistics is less about individual languages, and it's more about learning the rules that govern all languages.
Okay.
So like me and Jacob are in a phonetics and phonology course right now. So we are covering, phonetics is the study of sounds, and then phonology is the study of sound patterns. So with each language, you get different sound patterns that occur with certain sounds, and you also get a new set of sounds. So like German has a different set of sounds than Spanish or French would. But yeah, it's just more, it's like the scientific study of languages as a whole.
Cool.
Yeah. Any other questions?
Do they have, French-specific linguistics classes at UNH? Because I know there's Spanish phonetics class.
Yeah. I don't think they do. I know that they have the Spanish.
German-specific.
They don't have a German-specific. I think they just have the Spanish. Yeah? Yeah. But I think it's just because Spanish is a bigger major in general. Linguistics and German are both fairly small majors. I know linguistics, when I first got into UNH, maybe had 60 students in it in total, and we only had 3 professors. We were down to 2, and now we're back up to 3. And same thing with German, we only have 3 professors. So you get to know your professors very well, and they're all super nice, so don't feel intimidated by that.
Else. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.